Hi everyone, we are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. And then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session, and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder, your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_app. I'm eagerly looking forward to all your submissions right after this class.
Hello, everybody. How is everyone doing today? I hope everybody is doing great and everybody is excited for another class of watercolor food illustrations, right? Okay. So before we get into the class, let me remind you that there were the submission instructions at the beginning of the class, which if you have missed, we'll be playing it again at the end of the class and you can have a look there. Okay, so remember to make your submissions accordingly. All right, so what are we going to learn in today's watercolor class? In today's class, we are going to learn how to make a nice, tasty donut. I hope most of you have had a donut, right? It's very, very yummy. And it will have a nice pink glazing cream on top of it, okay? And it will look as if you've taken a bite from it. So it will be half eaten, right? So that you get the real feel as if while painting, you are actually eating a donut, okay? So what are all the things that we'll need for the class? Let us quickly go through them so that we can dive into the class early, right? Let me just pull up the class for you. Okay, so let us first see what are all the materials that we need for today's class. All right, so what are the things? We'll firstly need our paper or the drawing copy. We'll need a jar of water. Okay, and we'll need our watercolors and our pencil and eraser. All right, we'll need our brushes as well for watercoloring. And obviously our watercolors. So these are all of the things that you will need for today's class. Everybody just quickly get them ready and get ready with your pencil and eraser so that we can make the drawing of the donut. Okay. The painting part is very, very easy. The drawing portion, you need to learn a little bit. Okay. So everybody get ready with your pencil. And when you draw very lightly on your paper so that in case you make mistakes, you can erase it off with the eraser. Okay, so everybody remember, you will be drawing very lightly on the paper. Draw very lightly so that you are able to erase it very easily. All right, everybody just quickly get ready with your pencil and eraser and we'll dive into the class. All right. Okay. So let us see. This is my pencil. So see here, first we'll make a nice arc shape, okay, like this. This is the outermost shape of our donut. So see how we'll be drawing it. Okay, nicely draw this outermost shape. Everybody just complete drawing it. Everybody just draw a nice round shape like this. Not a complete circle, but somewhat round in shape. Okay, everybody complete drawing this. The drawing part, you will have to pay a little attention in this particular drawing. Painting part is very easy and you will enjoy it. So only your hard work is till the drawing part. Everybody get the drawing correctly. You will enjoy the painting. All right. Everybody has drawn the shape. Now time for the second shape. Okay, everybody, starting from here, we will make a little surface like this. It's just a very rough, broken surface. Okay, and we'll join up these two ends. So your donut is eaten from this side. Okay, somebody has taken a bite like this from this side. So that is why it is not circular. It is somewhat rough, as if somebody has taken the donut and like this has taken a bite. Everybody complete drawing this. Draw just a rough shape like this, a rough line joining the two ends. Everybody complete drawing this. Okay, now next we'll move on to the third part, another line drawing part. Everybody just pay attention. So starting from here, we'll draw a shape like this. Just randomly like this. Again, see, you don't have to draw exactly like I draw. Only the direction should be the same. Okay? Only the direction should be the same. The little things that I have made in between, you can make them as you like. Just that the direction should be somewhat like this, circular only. In between, there are a little bit of just movements of the line like this. The general shape should be the same. Rest of it, you can do as you like. Everybody complete drawing this third line. If you get the drawing correctly, your painting will turn out to be amazing. Always remember, no matter whatever you're drawing, your drawing portion should be very accurate and very nicely done. Even if your drawing is done correctly, then even if your painting lacks quality, even if it is not up to the mark, it will look at least decent. Okay, it will look good. But if your drawing itself is not good, no matter how much you work on your painting, it will not look that nice. So always focus on getting your drawing correct. Okay, pay proper attention when you're drawing so that the final result of your effort will look very good. Everybody got it? Okay. So now we'll move on to the next line. Just see. Again, we'll start from here. Just another thin line bordering that first line. Okay, just another thin line bordering that line. Okay, just draw it till here. You can see it's a rough line because when you take a bite like this, there is no fixed shape. It's just the shape of your teeth biting in, right? So we are just drawing a rough line like this. If you are feeling bored, don't worry. Just a few minutes work left. And after that, when you see the final result, you will really appreciate the work that you've put in. Okay? We are just going line by line so that nobody misses out on anything. Don't worry. Just a little bit of effort left. And after that, you will enjoy the painting process. Okay? I hope everybody has drawn this line. Now next, we'll draw the line. It will just join it to the end like this. We are almost at the end of our drawing. Good job, everybody who has pulled through. Just draw this line and it will join it to the end of the circle. Good job, everybody. Everybody is putting in patience, hard work. I know it is very difficult to draw, right? Painting is fun, but drawing is a little bit boring. I can understand. But remember, if you get your drawing correct, your painting will automatically look very nice. Okay? And if your drawing is not proper, no matter how much hard work you put in your painting, it will still not look that good. Okay? Yes. So next, we'll draw another line now. We'll just join this like this. Okay, just join this like this. So the hard part is done. Now we will just make the hole in the center of the donut. Just one small circle in the center of the donut. That is all. Everybody quickly get this done, this last part, so that we can move to the final portion of our drawing. And then we can have all the fun with the painting. Painting is very, very easy. Only your drawing should be proper for this particular illustration. Okay, now finally the center of the donut. So just see a nice little circular shape in the center of the donut. We are just making that hole in the center of the donut. Okay, a nice little shape like this. You can make it circle or you can add a little bit of bump like this so that it looks real. Because when you have a donut in reality, it's not an exact circle. It is somewhat roughly in the shape of a circle. So that is why we've just made a little bit of bump like this. But you can draw a simple circle also. That will also do. Okay. Just one simple circle like this in the center of the donut. And then we'll finally add the dimension to it. Because our donut is a 3D structure, we'll finally add the dimension to it so that it looks as if there is some width on the other side also. That completes your drawing. Everybody just get the drawing completed and we'll then move on to the painting. Take your time, everybody. Complete the painting, complete the drawing, so that we can move on to the painting. While you complete the drawing, let me tell you. So there will be a cream portion on the top of the donut and the rest of the donut is the bread. Okay, the bread portion. So the top of the donut, I will be using a pink color cream. Now you are free to use whatever color cream you want. If you want a red color cream or if you want chocolate cream, then you can use dark brown color also. So that is completely up to you what color cream you want. Okay, just that it should be nice and bright. Please don't use black color for cream because it will not look good. Okay, you can use nice bright colors. Use blue, use pink, green, your orange, red, brown. Okay, use all of these colors. Don't use grays and blacks. Okay, so everybody just choose the color in your mind, whatever color you want to apply for the cream. You can use your own colors or you can use pink color like I'm using. Those of you who have finished the drawing, pour out your color and get your brushes and be ready. We'll move on to the painting portion. For the bread portion, we'll be using yellow. Okay, it's a darker shade of yellow. If you don't have a dark yellow, you can use brown also for the bread portion. All right, everybody got my point? So just see here, everybody, we'll start off with the cream portion. So see here, I've taken my brush. Just dip it in a little bit of water. And here I have taken my pink color. Okay, it's a dark pink color. So see how I will apply it. I will not completely color it. See how I'm going to apply it. Nicely take the color on your brush, okay? And we'll first apply the color on all the sides of this cream portion. So see, I will first apply the color on all the sides of this creamy portion. Just keep taking the color and apply it on all the sides of this cream portion. Same for the inside also. We'll just border this small circle. That's all. See, we are only applying the color to the borders. That's all. Okay, we are not applying any color in the center. This portion also, we'll apply the color. Right, everybody get it done till here. We'll first apply the color on all the sides of the outer circle and the inner circle also. Everybody get this done. Everybody just complete this. Now next, we'll first wash our brushes in the water. Okay, and we'll just take the water. Just wash your brushes nicely in the water and we'll just take the water and see, we'll drag the color from all the sides. So see everybody, we'll just drag the color from all the sides towards the center. We have not put any color in the center. We'll just drag the color from all the sides towards the center. Again, take more water and we'll just drag the color from all the sides. Just pull the color with your brush. Just keep taking water. You can see I'm not taking any fresh color. I'm just taking water and I'm dragging the color from all the sides where I have applied the color and I'm pulling it towards the center. Okay, so get this done, everybody. Everybody get this done. Okay, everybody just let your paper dry now for some time. Okay, don't be too harsh on your paper. Just let it dry for some time. Meanwhile, we'll work on the bread portion. Okay, so everybody just take your brush. We'll move on to the next color. So see, like I said, we'll be using a dark shade of yellow. If you don't have yellow, you can use brown also. So see, this is the shade of yellow I will be using for the bread. Okay, nicely take your brush and nicely load up the color on your brush. And we'll apply it like this. We'll try to apply the same method. That is, first we'll cover up the borders. First we'll cover up the borders and then we'll move towards the center. We'll just work with water. So nicely, we are first covering up the borders. Same here also. First, we'll cover up the borders nicely. Same again for these lower portions also. Same yellow color I'm using. Okay, the same yellow color I'm using. I've just applied it to the borders and to these corner portions. I have left all these portions in the center empty because there we will work with water, just like we've done with the pink portion. Okay, after you're done covering all of these surfaces, just wash your brush in the water. Just wash off your brush in the water. First, complete all of these surfaces. See where I have applied the yellow color? Apply the yellow color in all of these portions. Leave the spaces in between white and then wash off your brush nicely. Okay, everybody. Now, once you have applied the same technique now that we have applied to the pink portion. Okay, now I don't have any color on my brush. It's just water. I've just washed off my brush in water and I'm just dragging the color towards the center using my brush, just how we've done with the pink portion. See, you can make out. I'm just pulling the color towards the center. That's all. I'm not having any color on my brush. It's just water. I'm just dipping it in water. That's all. And I'm just pulling the color from the sides and I'm putting it in these white places. Same for this portion also. Everybody just complete till here. Everybody complete till here. So see, you can make it out right now, right? How it's looking as if somebody has taken a bite of the donut. Everybody just complete till this part. We've just got a little bit more left. Everybody just complete till this part. Okay, now for the next step, just take a nice thin brush, okay, and we'll now use the brown color to border up all of the places. If you are already using brown for the bread, you can use black for this step, okay. You can see I've taken a nice thin brush, just nicely take some black or the brown color. If you don't have brown, you can use black also, okay. Just nicely take up some brown color and using that we'll border all of the surfaces. So see, nicely we'll border up all of these surfaces. If your paper is too wet, you can leave this for now. You can complete it once your painting dries up a little bit. Or if you have sketch pens, you can use that also. If you have a brown sketch pen or a black sketch pen, you can use that also for this step. Okay, nicely border up all of these. You can use a brush or you can use a sketch pen also. Whatever you have with yourself. If you feel that a sketch pen is easier, you can use a sketch pen. If you feel that your brush is easier to handle, you can use a brush. If your color is spreading like this, don't worry. It's completely natural. Your paper is wet. So it's better if your color spreads out. You can even leave a few dots like this in this portion so that it looks as if you have really taken a bite. You can leave a little bit of dots like this here. So that it looks as if there is some layer in the bread and you've taken a bite of it. Okay. So using the brown color, we have completed all of this. We'll just border this portion also. So this part, this that we just did, was called applying the shadows. Okay. So see how nice and real your donut is looking. It looks as if there's a nice glaze on the top, and it looks as if somebody has taken a bite of it, right? So what all did you learn in today's class? In today's class, you learned 3D drawing, right? You may not have realized it, but you learned how to make a 3D object. See, your drawing is looking real. It's looking as if somebody is looking at it from the side, okay? And not just the top view. So it looks three-dimensional. Your drawing was difficult because of the three-dimensional property, okay? And apart from that, you learned how to drag your watercolors, how to leave shiny surfaces like this, the one that you've left on the pink color and the yellow color, how to leave all these surfaces. So you learned all of these things in today's class. And plus, you have a nice tasty donut, right? Yes. So I want to see all of your nice and beautiful submissions in the submissions column. And remember, if you make a submission for the class, you are eligible for a certificate, right? And also the best top 10 submissions will be featured on the website. So that's a very good thing to look forward to. So I hope to see all of your efforts, all of the efforts you've put in the drawing, because I know this was a little bit of tough drawing, right? So I hope to see all of your drawings in the submissions. Okay. All right, everybody. I hope everybody learned something new and this class was useful for you, right? And I hope you will join all the other classes and we'll get to see each other again. Okay, everybody. Take care. Bye-bye. See you all again in the next class.
Hi, everyone. We are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. And then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder. Your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_app.